Higher Life in Christ, sponsored by Brother Leo Quadros.
And the time came when the man of God, Pastor Chris, mounted the pulpit with a rousing ovation from all around the auditorium. Indeed, the time for change, increase, and glory has come. On the first night of this three-day conference, the man of God, Pastor Chris, ministered spirit-lifting words, amongst which he taught extensively on the certain kind of mentality a minister of the gospel must have, and also that there is no place in the ministry for weakness.
I tell people there are no sissies in God's army. Even if you're a woman, you can be a woman, but don't be womanish.
Unravel the divine mysteries of these teachings as Pastor Chris taught extensively on the ministry of the Holy Spirit. Be inspired and be enthused by the glory of God as you watch.
Hallelujah. You know, Christianity has been in the world for so many years, right? Almost 2,000 years. And so we're not the first. We're not the first Christians. Am I right?
Yes.
We're not the first to be here. Some others started what we are taking on. And the beautiful thing about it is, they all had respect for the same material that has been delivered to us, the scriptures, the word of God. And through the scriptures, we can tell whether we are moving in the right direction or in the wrong direction. If you're honest as a Christian, and you're honest with the word of God, the Holy Scriptures, the Bible, you cannot be deceived. And if you ever got deceived and you open your heart to the scriptures, honestly, you will not be deceived for too long. Praise God. And so that helps us with the confidence of knowing that even though we may come from different backgrounds in Christianity, we may have been raised from different denominations. As long as we have respect for the same material, which is the Bible, the Word of God, it'll be easy for us to understand and agree on major issues. Hallelujah. Without the fear or concern that you might just be misled by hearing something that's not supposed to be true. Well, we've got the Bible. Thank God for the ability to read and write that most of us have. And today the Bible is in so many different languages. So that helps us, at least for the major issues. Glory to God. So be comfortable. You're in the right place. Tell somebody, be comfortable, you're in the right place. Hallelujah. Of course, as you know, we are raised and exposed by the Spirit of God to different things and in different ways. But one day, we will get to know even as we are known. Can I read something to you from the Bible? Visions chapter number 4. I'm reading from verse 8. Wherefore he saith, when he ascended up on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts unto men. Now that he ascended, what is it but that he also descended first into the lower parts of the earth? He that descended is the same also that ascended up far above all heavens, that he might fill all things. Look at verse 11. And he gave some apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers. Did you see that? For a purpose, and that's in the 12th verse, for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, that we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro, and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness whereby they lie in wait to deceive, but speaking the truth in love, may grow up into him in all things, which is the head, even Christ. Hallelujah. From whom the whole body fitly joined together and compacted by that which every joint supplieth, according to the effectual working in the measure of every part, make it increase of the body unto the edifying of itself in love. I'm reading from verse 8. Wherefore he saith, when he ascended up on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts unto men. Now that he ascended, what is it but that he also descended first into the lower parts of the earth? He that descended is the same also that ascended up far above all heavens, that he might fill all things. Look at verse 11. And he gave some apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors and teachers. Did you see that? For a purpose, and that's in the 12th verse, for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, that we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro, and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness whereby they lie in wait to deceive, but speaking the truth in love, may grow up into him in all things, which is the head, even Christ. Hallelujah. From whom the whole body fitly joined together and compacted by that which every joint supplieth, according to the effectual working in the measure of every part, make it increase of the body unto the edifying of itself in love. I'm just thinking, if you were an interpreter and you were trying to interpret from my reading, it would have been a difficult job. I'm sure what you chose to do was to just read from your Bible in that language. You know, sometimes when you read in the epistles, especially the Pauline epistles, there are several long verses, sometimes even not properly punctuated, but in such a way that could give you a difficult meaning without careful study. But this one is easy, even though it's long. Glory to God. But what I wanted you to notice was that God gave gifts to men. And these gifts, which we call ministry gifts, which are anointed men and women of God, called in several areas, in different areas, He gave them for the perfecting of the saints, to bring the saints of God, God's children, to a place of understanding, a place of knowledge, a place of maturity, so they can live the life that God has given to them in Christ Jesus. So the ministry of the Holy Spirit that's given to each one of us to carry out is a very, very powerful thing. It's a great responsibility, bringing others to the knowledge of God. Bringing others to the knowledge of God. And there is a certain kind of mentality that you must have as a minister of the gospel. And I want to explain that a little to you. There is no place in ministry for weakness and, you know, the beggarly mind and praying and asking, God, give me this, give me that, and give me the other one. There's no place in ministry for weakness. I tell people there are no sissies in God's army. Even if you're a woman, you can be a woman, but don't be womanish. They're two different things. No weakness for the minister who's been called into the ministry of the gospel. There is a mentality that you must have. The thing is, you don't get to acquire that mentality from your mother's womb. And you don't get it because you like it. You don't even get it by praying for it. It's in the calling. It's a requirement. It's something that God demands of you. Let me read to you from Joshua chapter 1. Let's see how God calls this man and how he talks to him. Joshua chapter 1, we'll begin reading from verse number 1. Now after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spake unto Joshua the son of Nun, Moses' minister, saying, Moses, my servant, is dead. Now therefore arise, go over this Jordan, thou and all these people, unto the land which I do give to them, even to the children of Israel. Every place that the sole of your foot shall tread upon, that have I given unto you, as I said unto Moses. From the wilderness and this Lebanon, even unto the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and unto the great sea, toward the going down of the sun, shall be your coasts. There shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with thee. I will not fail thee, nor forsake thee. Are you listening to that now? Okay. Be strong. Now here's the instruction. Be strong and of a good courage. Now look at, God says, Moses is dead. Now, I want you to take these people to the land that I promised their fathers to give them. And then he lets them know the extent of that land. He says, it's from here to there and there and there. Then he says to him, no man shall be able to stand before you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. Joshua had been with Moses. He knew what it was like when Moses was there. He was never defeated. God Almighty was with him. And now this same God who was with Moses talks to him and says, no man shall be able to stand against you all the days of your life. What a message that is. There's no room for fear. Now look at that. Go back to verse 6. He says, be strong and of a good courage. It doesn't matter that they took your building away. Are you hearing me? It doesn't matter that the government walked in and seized your property. Makes no difference. He says, be strong and of a good courage. For honor these people, shall thou divide for an inheritance the land which I swore unto their fathers to give them. Next verse. Only be thou strong. See, this is his requirement. Only be thou strong and what? Very courageous. Very courageous. I'll never forget, many years ago, there's a minister who was conducting a minister's conference. And I happened to have been watching the program on television. And then he said to the people, to the ministers, he says, you know, we all get discouraged sometimes. Then he said to them, sometimes I get discouraged. I thought, dear God, then he shouldn't be there. Yeah. The first thing God spoke to me, first time I ever heard the voice of God, that's what he told me. He said, be strong and very courageous. He told me what I was going to do, what the ministry was going to be. And he said to me, be strong and very courageous. And I've kept to it. Yeah. I've kept to it exactly. And so when you say, you know, as ministers, sometimes we get discouraged. I wonder, where are you coming from? How could you? That means you were brought up wrongly. And what that minister was doing to them that day was helping them to grow up wrong. You know, some people grow up wrong in life. Don't grow up wrong. Don't say, you know, sometimes I feel discouraged. If that happens to you, you've been listening to the wrong thing. And it's produced a negative mentality in you. Do you know what it is to be a man or woman of God? You know what that means? I have a question for you. Can something happen to God?
No.
When I was younger in the things of the Spirit, I used to sing one song because I learned it from older Christians many years ago. Something wonderful, great and marvelous, something good is going to happen to you. Then we go, something good is going to happen to you. We sang it for years. I loved the song. But one day while I was singing it, Spirit of God said to me, I don't want any something good to happen to you. I thought, Lord. He said, I don't want something good to happen to you. I don't want something bad to happen to you either. I said, so what? He said, change the song. He said, I want you to happen. Yeah. You know, I didn't get the theology of it first. I just first got the instruction. And very quickly I accepted what he said, but I needed scripture. And then the Lord started showing me through the word. I just asked you a question, does something happen to God? You're ministers of the gospel. I'm asking you, does something happen to God? Can something happen to him? When you become a man of God, you are so identified with him, you become the hand of God and the mouth of God.
Yes.